Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today is August 2nd, 2019, which means that I'm exactly 1 year on immunotherapy today. So I thought that I would do a little bit of an update and give you guys a review and answer some questions that you all have asked on some of my previous immunotherapy updates. I feel like I don't really have that many updates from my last video that I made. My allergies keep getting better and better. And overall, as I've said in previous videos, I'm so glad that I decided to do this. My allergies are pretty much cured now. Before I started immunotherapy, my allergies were probably the worst that they've ever been in my entire life. And they're actually so bad that I got sores on my fingers. I did use steroid cream for a while that my doctor prescribed, but I think that the immunotherapy really helped them to go away. I'm going to talk more about my thoughts through the questions, but overall this was definitely really worth it and I would highly recommend it to anyone out there. The first question that I'm going to answer, which is a question that I get asked all the time, is do the shots hurt? I don't think that anyone really enjoys getting shots. They hurt a little bit, but it's really not that bad. And for me, at least since I'm pretty young, I'd rather just do this now and deal with it and then have my allergies pretty much go away for the rest of my life. So yes, they do hurt, but shots are the only option for immunotherapy right now. So if you really hate shots and you really hate needles, then you probably shouldn't do this because you have to get a shot every single week for at least 6 months. The next question is, was immunotherapy worth it? Seems like it takes a lot of time. As I already said, yes, it was completely worth it. I did have to go to an allergy clinic and wait there for 30 minutes after my shot, but it was definitely worth it, and now I only have to go once or twice a month. The next question is, did you have any bad reactions to the shots? I never got held at the clinic. I never had to use an EpiPen or anything like that, but I did experience some swelling, especially in the beginning, and I did get a physical allergic reaction on my skin for probably about the first 6 months or so. Shots definitely did make my allergies seem worse than they were before. My throat would get really sore and I would sometimes come really close to losing my voice after doing a lot of outreach, but that would usually go away within a day or two and the reaction would go away pretty soon too. Another bad reaction or side effect that I would have is that my eyes would always get really itchy or red. They still kind of do, probably because I spend a lot of time outside. My doctor prescribed me these eye drops at my very first appointment last July and these have really helped me a lot. So if your eyes are getting really itchy or red and over-the-counter eye drops aren't working, you should definitely ask your doctor for a prescription for something better. I'm gonna be honest, immunotherapy is not a fun experience. You will suffer, you'll experience a lot of symptoms, but you have to make the decision of whether or not it's worth it. The next question that I'm gonna answer, which is only really relevant for people that live near me, is what clinic do you go to? I personally go to the Palo Alto Medical Foundation Los Gatos Allergy Clinic. There aren't really that many options in my area. If you have Kaiser, you go to Kaiser. And if you have anything else, you have to go to one of the Palo Alto Medical Foundation clinics. They have the one in Los Gatos that I go to. They have one in Mountain View and they have one in Palo Alto. And I think they have a few others now as well. So I would definitely recommend Palo Alto Medical Foundation clinics. I've had a good experience with the one that I go to. But I feel like in most areas, there aren't really that many options when it comes to immunotherapy. So I would suggest just picking whichever clinic takes your insurance because it's extremely expensive without insurance. And I guess I'll talk about that too because I did get another question about the cost. When I first started the process, I had Aetna insurance, which completely covered the allergy tests that I needed, the shot solution, and all of my shots. So the only thing that I had to pay for was the doctor's appointments, which I think was a $60 copay. Without insurance, the test would have been $1,200. The shot solution would have been about $900. And the shots would have been about $50 each. So if you're planning on going on immunotherapy and you don't have a lot of money, definitely look into which insurance plans cover it. Aetna is definitely a really good option because they just completely cover everything that you need. So if you've never had an allergy test done or the one that you have is really outdated, I would highly recommend getting Aetna because they will completely cover it and you can't get on immunotherapy without getting an allergy test. So they need to know what substances to put in your shot solution. So those were all the questions that I could find. I didn't scroll all the way back to my first videos. But if you have any other questions, feel free to comment them down below and I'll try my best to answer them. But I'm not a doctor. I don't know everything about this. So if you're interested in it, definitely talk to a doctor and try to get an appointment at an allergy clinic. So thank you all so much for watching. Stay awesome and I'll see all of you very soon with a new video. Goodbye.